linear equations in one variable. That's our topic for today. Lot of big words there. Linear, equation, variable. Let's see if we can understand all of these. Let's start with equation. So what is an equation? Equation equal to, looks like something like equal, right? What is an equation? In very simple words, an equation is nothing but a comparison. This is equal to this. Both of these are exactly the same. I am as tall as my brother. How could you write it as a mathematical equation? My height equal to my brother's height. That is nothing but saying I'm as tall as my brother. This is nothing but an equation. What it tells you is there's an equal to sign in between. And what is on the two sides of it is exactly the same. So my height and my brother's height is exactly the same. That's what an equal to. That's what an equation does. Now if I tell you Sachin scored a century, how do you write that? Sachin's score is equal to a century. Or Sachin's score equal to 100 runs. That is, Sachin scores and 100 runs, or Sachin score and a century, is one and the same thing. That is what an equation does. Now, an equation could be about fun things like my height and Sachin's score, or it could be about more boring things like algebraic expressions. Do you remember algebraic expressions? You saw things like 3x squared, 4x minus 5, y by 5 plus z, and so on. These were all algebraic expressions. Now you pick any two of these and put an equal to sign in between, and voila, you have an equation. That's what an equation is. It says the two sides of the equal to sign are exactly the same. It doesn't tell you what is on the two sides. It could be sentences, it could be algebraic expressions, it could be numbers, it could be anything. That's what an equation is. So we have an equation. We've understood what an equation. We had three words to understand, right? Linear equations in one variable. Now, variable. You already know what variables are. A variable is nothing but an unknown, a quantity which is not known. So all the x, y's and z's that you see in this expression are nothing but variables. Any unknown quantity, that is a variable. We are going to deal with equations in only one variable. So we don't want an equation like this with three variables. We want a simpler one with just one variable. Let's say 2x minus 5 equal to 3. It's an equation in one variable. X squared plus 2 equal to 5. Again, an equation in one variable. So there's only one unknown quantity. Everything else is known. All the other things are known. Great. So it has an equal to sign. It is an equation. It has only one variable. So it is in one variable. Now, what is this linear? What does linear tell you? Linear is nothing but if you look at the highest power of the variable. In the first case, look at the first equation. What is the highest power of x? 1. Right? Because only x is nothing but x raised to 1. So the highest power of x here is 1. In the second expression, you have an x square here. So what is the power of x? X is raised to 2. Or the power of x is 2. So this, the second expression here, the second equation here is not a linear equation because the power of x is 2. So get rid of this. This is a linear equation in one variable. Satisfies all three of our conditions. It's an equation, it's linear, has only one variable. So that's what a linear equation is. It has the highest power of the variable is 1. And why do we call this as linear is something you learn later. All of these expressions, if you start visualizing them, they'll be straight lines, which is why we call them linear, like a line. So three conditions, highest power of the variable is 1, only one variable, equal to sign has to be there. That's all that linear equations in one variable. And what do they help us do? Basically, an equation, like we said, compares two things, right? So if you have an unknown, put an unknown on one side and a known on the other, put an equal to sign in between, and you can solve it to find out the value of the unknown. So they basically help us to find unknown quantities. In any given situation, if you have some information with some quantities unknown and some known, using the known quantities, you find the unknown. That's what an equation really helps you do. You can visualize an equation as being a beam balance. So the left-hand side on the left pan and the right-hand side on the right pan. And the equal to sign tells you that even if I remove my hands, this is going to stay in perfect balance. It's not going to tilt to one side or the other. The key to solving an equation is always maintaining this balance. If you disturb the balance, you're getting the answer wrong. As simple as that.
If you like this video and want to watch many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.